the leader in talk radio on the internet, right here on K98Talk.com.
Is debt beating you down? You need discipline. You need the Debt Ninja. If you've been caught in a financial trap and need to be set free, then you need the Debt Ninja. Want to stop those harassing collection calls, start saving thousands in interest and fees, and get out of debt fast? Then you need to call the Debt Ninja. The Debt Ninja will find the best companies across the country that will help you consolidate all your bills into one easy payment, reduce your payments by 30 to 50%, and get you out of debt fast. If you have unsecured debt of $10,000 or more, such as credit cards, loans, or medical bills, call the Debt Ninja for a free 15-minute consultation.
Call 800-826-1246. 800-826-1246. That's 800-826-1246. Call today.
The Debt Ninja.
This is Slickery Trigger for Rebel Road Tactical. With proper care and feeding, your pistol will be ready when you need it. There to save your life. Shouldn't your gear be that good? Whether you need a holster for comfortable everyday carry, or a tough-as-nails holster for your next training course, Rebel Road Tactical has what you need. Check us out on the web at rebelroadtactical.com.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
In these uncertain economic times, you've got to do whatever you can to save money. One of our biggest expenses can be our cars, especially when unexpected repair bills hit. Not anymore. If you own a vehicle with less than 130,000 miles, is less than 12 years old, has a warranty about to expire, or even no warranty at all, you could stop paying for car repairs. Roadside assistance, towing, and rental coverage are all included. Don't wait for the next repair. Make one free call right now to see if you qualify. If you're vehicle is less than 12 years old, has less than 130,000 miles, even if it's out of warranty, paying for car repairs can become a thing of the past. Call us right now and get your car protected before your next repair bill hits. Get protection and no more repair bills. Call 800-696-1030. Again, 800-696-1030. That's 800-696-1030. 800-696-1030.
All right, folks, this is Rick Robinson with you. I want to tell you about some friends of mine from a company called Security Enforcement Specialists. When I ran my security agency for 12 years, I worked with one of these partners on a daily basis. He's been involved in this agency now, and with his other partner, they do have over 30 years of experience in the private security industry. If you own a business and you need someone to keep you or your customers or residents safe, then I highly recommend contacting Security Enforcement Specialists today. Give them a call at 405-703-1796. Again, that's 405-703-1796. Again, tell them Rick from K98 Talk sent you. Like I said, if you need the help, they are here for you. So make sure that you go look them up, check them out, and see what they can do. The wrong way.
Welcome to the place. Individuals and businesses with tax problems, listen carefully. Do you feel like you're losing control over your finances? If you owe over $10,000 in back taxes or have unfiled tax returns, we can help you take back control. The IRS is the largest and most aggressive collection agency in the world, and they can seize your bank account, garnish your paycheck, close your business, and file criminal charges. Take control of your tax problems now by calling the experts at Tax Mediation Services and take advantage of the Fresh Start program and new laws that may allow us to negotiate a settlement for the lowest amount possible. Our team of tax attorneys and enrolled agents can stop collections and get you protected so you can take control of your financial future. Tax Mediation Services is accredited by the Better Business Bureau. Call now for a free case review and a price protection guaranteed quote.
Call Tax Mediation Services now at 800-610-9050. That's 800-610-9050. 800-610-9050.
The internet will never be the same. You're listening to K98Talk.com.
Good God, y'all.
What is it good for?
Absolutely.
Let's get started.
Ladies and gentlemen, he's a child of God, a husband, NRA conservative, radical right-wing supervillain, and Twitter rock star. American by birth, Texan by choice, and a badass by nature. He's the owner of TomOHalloran.com, OHalloranMedia.com, and PatriotRadio.net. Please welcome Tom O'Halloran.
There ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the U.S.
And good morning, America. Welcome to the Patriot Radio Show. I'm your host, Tom O'Halloran, and I'm broadcasting today from an underground bunker deep in Arkansas, Nebraska. I'm here to educate, irritate, and agitate. And folks, I'll guarantee you full agitation by the time this show's over, or you'll get triple your money back at the door. Again, my name's Tom O'Halloran. My primary blog, TomOHalloran.com. When you get there, please follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Spreaker, all the other social media that suits your fancy. You can also find us on Facebook at facebook.com/Patriot Radio Show. And let me back this noise down just a little bit. Mike, thanks for the heads up there. Personally, I'm on Facebook at facebook.com/O'Halloran. And we're on air 5 days a week, so please tune in 9 a.m. Texas time, Monday through Thursday, for this, the Patriot Radio Show. On Fridays, we do Jihad on America. There we cover the Islamists in America, sharing with you who they are, what they want, and why you should be afraid. If you did not catch my show on the Muslim Brotherhood, my show, Islam is Not a Religion, or my show on Islamophobia, then please find your way to PatriotRadioShow.com. Listen to all three of these shows. They will give you insight and perspective on the Islamic topic that you've probably not heard elsewhere. They'll also give you a solid foundation upon which we build each and every Friday as we continue to pull back the mask of Islam, looking at what's being done in the name of Allah, both here and abroad. And I do the news about Islam around the world because it's a glimpse into the future of what's in store for us if we continue to allow the cancer of Islam to spread here in the homeland. Keep abreast of my shows, listen to the live stream, as well as catch up on the archives of any shows you may have missed. all at patriotradioshow.com. This show is rebroadcast daily at confederatebroadcasting.com, on the conservativeradionetwork.com, on Liberty Works Radio Network, that's LWRN.net, and on rednationrising.us. You can also take the show on the road with you with your iPhone or Android. Just download the TuneIn app and do a search for The Patriot Radio Show. With that, we're going to go straight to the phone and bring in my good friend, Ken Crow. Ken, are you there, brother?
Good morning, sir. How are you today?
Man, it's like Christmas around here. I watched the DNC yesterday, and it was like a nonstop unwrapping of gifts.
It was an orgy of dysfunction. What?
Boy, oh boy, I'll tell you what, we got so much to cover today. Let's start with this.
Well, listen, I got something real quick. You asked me to do something for you.
Go ahead. I asked you to do two things. One, I read the column.
Okay.
So, go ahead.
Okay. I wanted to read your response to that on Facebook, and it's remarkable. For those who would like, Stop My Crow's Nest Politics group at Facebook, and I've got it pinned to the top. Tom did some outstanding research work a couple of days ago and found some very, very interesting emails that were leaked by WikiLeaks and other people, I guess. Anyway, he did this little article, and I expounded on it just a little bit and republished it. And you guys need to read the responses to this thing on Facebook, because it's remarkable. There's conservative responses and there's some liberal responses. But one of the responses that I got is from a fellow by the name of Jeff Borman. He's actually a friend of mine in Des Moines, and he's a political activist, and he's been from day one, a devoted Trump devotee, okay? He worked tirelessly, thousands of volunteer hours for the campaign and what have you. But he says, Ken Crow, I agree. Although I wanted Obama's policies to fail, I did want him to erode the very fiber of America. As the first black, I had hoped that he would have focused on rebuilding the inner cities by giving minorities the hope, inspiration, and resources to lift them out of poverty. Instead, he focused his energies on further dividing America, and this is relative to what you're getting ready to get into, Tom, I think. Pitting blacks and Hispanics against whites and the Republicans, Obama didn't want to address these issues because it didn't align with his racial leftist agenda to fundamentally transform America. Obama and the Democrats need a permanent voting class to help keep them in power. I've never lived in a more racist America than I have during the past 8 years. Now Obama has introduced reverse racism against whites. It's not racist to want to stop illegals, whether it be Hispanics, Muslims, or any other nationally or groups. Saying Mexico is sending its worst rapists and murderers is not racist. Saying we need to stop Muslims or all other immigration in the U.S., is not racist. Pointing out that the judge who is handling your court case is Hispanic and associated with Hispanic activist groups, and when they may be biased against you, is racist. How many times have blacks claimed that they can't get a fair trial with all the white jury? Saying that a cop killing a violent rioter group's BLM is racist and promoting hate is fact. The Republican Party freed the slaves, gave them voting rights, made sure they weren't treated as personal property. The Democrat Party is guilty of blocking all these efforts. And once the Republican Party accomplished this with their blood and through legislation, the Democrat Party started abusing their freedoms for their own political advantage, while Republicans want to help the black communities by giving them a hand up and by giving them jobs, better education, give them self-worth. The Democrats give them social benefits, treat them as victims, and abuse their trust by making them political tools and not as equal Americans. I must be racist because I believe all Americans should be treated equally and treated as victims, but rather people who need to be taught how to fish, not just fed. I found that to be an incredible response to your article, Tom.
Yeah, interesting.
Powerful.
The whole idea of a racist party has been so spun by the Democrats over the years that Mike Nelson, that was not on crowsnestpolitics.com, that was Crow's Nest group, our page over on Facebook.
Yeah, that's where I posted that. It's also, but those responses aren't there. I think everybody needs to read the responses from the left and the right, because it's very interesting.
Yeah, and the
two bipolars.
The article that the guy was referring to was an email sent from a senior VP at the DNC referring to a Taco Bowl outreach, referring to a Hispanic outreach that they were going to do. And just the very idea of referring to Hispanics as a Taco Bowl is, I mean, if a Republican had done that, he would be forced to resign immediately. But here we have the head of the DNC being forced out, forced to resign, forced to walk off the stage and not even gavel in the convention that she had worked quite hard to put together over the last year and a half. Not even allowed to gavel it in. Forced out because of collusion between her and the Hillary Clinton campaign. Instantly, what happens? Hillary Clinton hires her as a campaign chairperson. You're forced out for being crooked, so we're going to hire you on our team. Well, perfect. You're all crooks anyway, so I guess it kind of makes sense. But you would think that the Clintons would want to shy away from that visual. But no, they raise her up.
The Democrats, I listened to some of these speeches last night, and the Democrats are beyond hypocrisy. They passed hypocrisy long ago.
Yep.
And the one thing that seems to be missing in the media, and I'm wondering when they're going to get around to this, is we're now hearing Bernie and Hillary, and they've taken all the schism of and the narrative of we're living in tough times right now. People are unemployed. People need to be lifted up. Every day on the news, all we hear about is how great a job Obama's done
for
the economy. Now, which is it, folks? I'm confused here. We're either suffering, and everybody needs help.
Yeah, when Donald Trump talked about how bad it was, he was giving a dark speech. Now, these guys are coming out saying the same thing. It's bad.
Yeah.
It's bad because you guys have been running it.
Exactly. But we can't put Obama down at the convention. So we're just going to tell people two different things and expect them to not figure it out, I guess.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know what the hell they're doing.
Well, we're going to have another meltdown today, I think. Because yesterday Bernie Sanders stood up and said, we have to elect Hillary Clinton. His movement has gotten bigger than he is. He was an unlikely rock star from the beginning, but now he's trying to herd them to vote for Hillary. They are marching with signs saying Jill Stein, I think is her name, who's the Green Party delegate. A large swath of the Bernie people are going to vote for Jill Stein. And by large swath, he had 30 million people. If even a tenth of that goes to Jill Stein, Jill Stein will have more votes than Obama won by in 2012. Now, here's the thing that's going to set the fires today. It's just breaking that as early as early June, what, 6 weeks ago, 7 weeks ago, Bernie Sanders sent a memo to Hillary Clinton proposing that he endorse her at the convention. What he wanted in exchange was a private plane to fly around and campaign for her. What he wanted was a chance to vote on some minor planks on the platform. And what he wanted was credit for her winning the election. In other words, Bernie Sanders is a fraud. He spent the last year traveling around the country complaining about the elites, and he sells out for a private plane so he can fly around like one of the elites. He sold out. And these guys aren't just like cruise bots that are just dedicated to cruise. These guys are fanatics. I mean, they're like Occupy. They're anarchists.
Yeah.
They are anarchists. They aren't going to shut up. They will shout lock her up every day on the floor of the convention. These are not going to fall in line. And when they find out that he not only quieted down and came within the fold, but that he sold out for a private plane, they're going to be livid.
Yeah, they are.
They're going to be livid. And the story's just breaking this morning. So that's going to be... it's going to be another mess on the floor today.
Well, there is, you know... Hang on to your seat, Tom. Don't get upset before I can finish this thought.
But don't you start that with me now. Go ahead.
There is a lot of parallels between the Trump movement and the Bernie movement. There are. And what it was, Bernie was campaigning on anti-establishment, anti-Wall Street, anti-big business, blah, blah, blah. More jobs.
You talked about that many times.
Trump is campaigning on very similar things. So the followers of the two are actually not that far apart. The only difference is the Trumpsters are traditionally conservatives and Republicans and don't want free pot for everybody and think you ought to earn your own college education. But other than that, the point being, they're both anti-establishment.
Yep. Very much so. And if Jill Stein gets, let's say she gets 10% of the Bernie Sanders, and another 10 to 20% actually want their vote to count so they come over to Trump, Hillary's toast.
Well, sure.
With all that,
you're absolutely right.
With that,
100% correct.
With that, and then you add in the fact of the Taco Bowl outreach, the Hispanics are going to leave her. She's done. It's history. It's in the bag. We might as well just inaugurate Donald Trump now and get Obama out of the office this month.
Well, they mentioned it last night. And I don't recall who the Green. I think it was Ralph Nader or somebody. Last election garnered 3 to 4% of the vote. And on Fox, they were not discussing this. I watched MSNBC for a while. I watched CNN, Anderson Cooper, and watched Fox. They were discussing your point on Fox last night. That, look, you've got these tens of millions really hacked off. In fact, it was Tucker Carlson talking about it. Hacked off Bernie supporters if 5 to 10% of those sway to Jill Stein with her 3 to 4%, which she'll garner from the Green freaks, the tree huggers, and all those guys, they vote Green irregardless. The rest of the issues don't matter. Just Green matters. And if they go over because, we just can't vote for Republican, we got to vote. It works here, not vote for Hillary, so we'll vote for Jill, okay? And that's what Tucker says is going to happen. She's going to pick up 5, 6, 7, 8% of these Bernie supporters minimum, which is going to give her over 10% in the November elections. And if that's the case, then you're absolutely right, because Trump is. Tucker interviewed last night, did one of those walkthrough things. He was at a protest yesterday afternoon. He said he did not run into one Bernie supporter that did not say they were voting for Donald Trump.
Yeah.
Every one of them. So he said Trump's going to pick up a minimum of 10 to 15% of the Bernie supporters.
Yep.
And then when you add back the 6, 7, 8% going to Jill Stein, that's 20% of her block.
Well,
right,
see,
there.
And then there's another section. There's another section to that, because first off, we take the 3 to 5% that will go to Jill. Okay, so that's just a negative from Hillary. Then you've got the 10 to 15% that will go to Donald. That's a double strike, because now they're not voting for her and they are voting for him. So that's actually that's like matching funds in your IRA for everyone you get she doesn't get. Then you've got the other block, which is probably another 10 to 15% that just are tired of it and they're not going to go vote. So she's going to end up walking away, leaving 50% of 15 million people on the table.
Well, Tucker and the analysts at Fox are now to the point where they're saying she's going to do really well to pick up 40-42% of the vote.
40-42, okay.
And if that's the case, she's in trouble.
Yeah.
Because now, that's predicated. Keep in mind, this is the dark side to these predictions here. That's predicated on the fact that the cruisers fall in line and don't walk on Donald and put up protest votes like Sarah Palin and Roddy and Nikki Bell and everybody else.
Yeah.
If we get 80% of them to fall in line, we need about 80%, which I think is going to happen, because Trump has taken a really tough line. He's speaking today at the VFW convention in North Carolina that Hillary addressed yesterday. And he's just mopping the floor.
Yeah,
he's getting standing O's and everything else.
Him and Mike both did a great job there, and Hillary got a lukewarm applause in front of the VFW yesterday.
So, the only thing now, I'm prepared to say this, and I'm feeling really confident now. But the only thing that I can see that stops Donald from winning this now is Donald.
Yeah.
If Donald can watch his tongue, read from the teleprompter, stick with the narrative, stick with the messaging that's been done for him, and not go off in la-la land, which he's prone to do at times, if he can stay on message, we win.
Yeah.
That's bottom line.
Absolutely.
But he's going to have to stay away from these off-the-cuff, I'm not saying that they were anti-Hispanic, but they were construed to be that way, and it let the Dems twist and spin it that way. If he can stay away from remarks that can be construed as racism and things like that, we win.
Yeah.
It's that simple.
Well, he's
just gonna have to behave himself for a couple of months.
He
goes to the White House.
They are losing so many demographics. They're on the verge of losing the Hispanics when the Taco Bowl thing breaks. Yesterday on the sidelines, Hank Johnson, a congressman from Georgia, Democrat, compared Israeli settlers, the Jews living on the West Bank, compared them to termites. I mean, they are just pissing off every demographic that has ever come out and supported the Democratic Party. It's mind-boggling that they can be so callous and stupid.
Well, Bill made a comment here. I'm not saying don't let Donald be Donald. But where you're at now is every word that he utters, okay? I'll give you an example. Hillary's got a devastating ad out right now. And what it is, it shows a group of school kids watching the TV, and Donald's making these really, let's face it, guys, they were not good remarks. And then he's doing that little thing where he was making fun of the reporter that was, he didn't realize that the reporter was, handicapped, yeah. And he did that little thing. Well, that's now an ad, okay? And everything that Donald says from this point forward, if it's not clean and it's not good, they're going to use it in a commercial against him. And they will put a date on it, where he said it at, and, you know, the New Orleans Times has him doing this. And, you know, they're good at this, and they can do it within 24 hours. And they'll have an ad up on national television.
I'll tell you what else will be in an ad. I'll guarantee you the Democrats at the DNC chanting, "Lock her up." That will be in a Donald Trump ad.
Oh, absolutely.
Before the week is out. That was just too perfect. On the floor of the DNC.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, was that
delegates.
Classic.
They're all delegates.
As opposed to the Republicans, when you had a small faction, some of the Ted Cruz people were trying to get a motion passed. It was a smaller group of people, and it was a more civil thing, and it was a regular process. This was 42% of the delegates in the room all chanting in unison, "Lock her up." It was incredible.
And Tucker went around last night. Geraldo did too, on the floor of the convention. And Frank Luntz was the one talking about this morning. He too went around on the floor last night and interviewed many delegates. He said they were all warm to him. They were all friendly. They were all, you know, outgoing. They were nice people, he said. But he said, make no mistake about it, California is not going to back off. And you're talking about several hundred chairs down there chanting, "Lock her up."
Yep.
I mean, making noise. He said they are absolutely vehemently opposed to Hillary. He ran through four or five states, and one of them was California, who has a huge contingency on that floor.
Right.
And they can totally wreck the convention for you. There's so many of them.
And like
said, they're not changing.
And these are,
they're not changing, Tom.
And these
they're
are
not going to back off.
These are radicals. They're not polite suit and tie Republicans that are just going to make a little bit of noise in the beginning.
No.
These are anarchists. These are Bernie Sanders anarchists. And they are...
They are frothing at the mouth, laughing.
I haven't had so much fun with my clothes on in decades. Yesterday was absolutely a party over here. Now, I know you've got to go, but before you go...
Oh, it's all right.
I want your input. It's all right. I need to take this break then. When we come back, I want you to tell me your thoughts on the Donald Trump convention speech. All right?
Sure.
Okay. We'll be right back.
Yeah.
Stick around. It's the Patriot Radio Show on a Tuesday morning with Tom O'Halloran and my good friend Ken Crow. Don't touch that dial.
One place where you are guaranteed to find a great guy. You know, the kind of guy that carries you off on horseback and flies you to Paris and likes to talk about his feelings? He's at the movies. Well, in the movies. Where else will you find a funny architect with airbrushed abs? Girls are lining up for guys like this, but not you, because you bought your tickets ahead on Fandango. So adios, long lines, and hello, handsome astronaut, brain surgeon, spy.
Make a date with Fandango, your ticket to the movies.
Family night at the movies is a tradition. It really bonds us together. I love you guys so much. Especially this one.
I mean, of course, there's all the, his popcorn speaker's in mine, and she's hitting me.
Fandango makes it all so easy with tickets in advance. Honey, you enjoy the chick flick? Kids, you enjoy the animated movie? Daddy's gonna go watch things go boom. That's how we do family movie night.
Bring your family closer together with Fandango, your ticket to the movies.
Boost Mobile believes you deserve more choice.
You can pick your phone,
pick your plan,
and
you can even pick our new spokesperson
and a sell that phone.
The Samsung Galaxy S5 will walk your face off.
Give it to me through tears.
Get unlimited talk, text, and data. Starting at $40 a month.
Wow.
Pick your phone.
Pick your plan.
And pick your next spokesperson at BoostMobile.com.
Visit Boost Mobile through the RER Marketplace.
Hello, Patriots. This is Tom O'Halloran. I recently celebrated the show's second anniversary and 350th show. As I embark on my third year on the air, I'm asking each of you to consider showing your support for the show in a way that will make a real difference. While it's only an hour show, there are also 3 to 4 hours of show prep and another hour of cutting, posting, and promoting the show afterwards. This is nearly 2,100 hours spent gathering together the stories to enlighten you with on a daily basis. When a family man takes time away from the family to this degree, it's looked at as a hobby. But the thing about hobbies is that they are fun. This show is far from fun. It is work. Depressing work at times, but it's also become a calling too. Something that is needed to wake America up to the things that threaten our way of life. From the Islamic attacks on our soil to the LGBT invasion of our ladies' restrooms to the border situation and the out-of-control Congress. The point is, it takes time, and it costs money. Please take a minute to click on the red banner at the top of the center column and do what you can to keep this show on the air. And a heartfelt thank you to those of you that have been contributing and supporting the show all along, without which I would not have been able to stay on air as long as I have. Thank you, and God bless.
I reckon the storms are brewing. Reckon so.
Reckon you got a hotel?
Reckon no. Money's tight.
Reckon Priceline Express deals can get you a great deal. Wherever you mosey.
You reckon? We reckon.
I reckon our work here is done. Vamanos!
Express deals. Priceline savings without the bidding.
Think he's happy?
Ooh, I reckon.
Tom O'Halloran, holding the line against tyranny from Washington, D.C.
I am America. One voice, united we stand. I am America. One hope to heal our land. There is still work that must be done.
We're back. It's the Patriot Radio Show on a Tuesday morning. We're on the air with my good friend Ken Crow, who missed Donald Trump's speech during the convention that he drove like 17,000 miles to go to. He missed the speech live. So he watched it yesterday, and now we're going to get his review. Go ahead, brother.
It just wouldn't be a great day if I wasn't insulted by Trump.
You're not being insulted. You're just being ribbed. Yeah, okay.
it just wouldn't be a fulfilling day. Okay, Donald Trump's speech. I'm not going to say a whole lot about it, but other than the fact that it was remarkable, it was extraordinary. cadence was perfect. The verbiage was perfect. He addressed all the major issues and gave solutions, although not real specific solutions. And I understand why. You don't want to make promises that you can't fulfill. But in turn, you want to tell people what you're going to try to do. And he did that. And, you know, he didn't stand up and make fluffy promises. Other than he's going to get this done one way or another.
Yep.
And I like that, okay? I like the person that stands up and says, you know what, I'm going to try to do this. Can't make any promises as a result, but I'm going to try to do this.
Yeah.
And he did that, okay? You know, he's being ripped by the Democrats for not being real specific and all, but they're not either.
Right.
You know, there's absolutely nothing Hillary Clinton can say. I just put out a tweet a minute ago that said, Dems in Philly speak about the unemployment building a better economy when they also speak of Obama's incredible accomplishments, hashtag hypocrisy.
Exactly.
And that's what they're doing. You know, that's exactly what they're doing. But Donald's speech was a great speech. I thought it was a bit long. I thought he could have probably cut 15, 20 minutes off of it.
I don't know that
that's
he could.
Okay.
I don't know that he could and still
know,
have,
that,
the, and still have
okay.
the effect. Because, I mean, the flow of it was incredible. He starts off he starts off with crime stats, actual facts, real data that has been fact-checked and tried to be picked apart, but his numbers were spot on. So,
well, it was FBI. It was FBI reported that as what he used.
So here's the facts. Then he points to the cause, their failed policies, the failed leadership of the administration, Hillary Clinton's criminality. And then he moves into his vision. So it's, here's where we're at, here's why we're here, and here's where I can help out and what I can do. The flow of it was incredible. What did I tell you about his pauses, his asides to the script?
Oh, they were, the timing and the cadence was perfect.
Wasn't it?
Whoever wrote that speech for him, which I'm sure is probably three or four or five people.
I believe it was
one
primary person. He mentioned the name in one of his interviews. He mentioned the person's name and gave him credit for it. But, absolutely.
Yeah, I mean, the guy had Trump's, you know, there's a special relationship, and it's built over time.
You
can't do it instantly between a speechwriter and the office holder or candidate or whoever. And it's something that takes time to do.
Peggy Noonan had Ronald.
Trump nailed.
Yeah, he had Trump nailed like Peggy Noonan had Ronald Reagan. I mean, he just...
Exactly.
Spot
so whoever wrote that, Trump needs to bring him to the White House. He needs to be supervising all speeches.
Right?
Mr. Trump, because he did an incredible job.
I told you, it was as good of a speech as I've ever heard anybody deliver on any topic.
It was as good, you know, I gotta get, you know, let's face it. Obama is an incredible orator. And as much as we hate him, the guy managed to move a nation with no resume to do it. And he did it through his speaking. The guy is, without question, since Abraham Lincoln, one of the greatest speech deliverers of all time, okay? As long as he's got the monitor, Obama can knock every speech out of the ballpark. Well, Trump did that the other night. He was as good as, I'm not going to say he was as good as Obama because he still needs a little more practice, but I got to tell you, the guy hit a home run.
The difference between them is when Trump does an aside, goes off the script, he's speaking from the heart, and it's clear, and it's understandable. When Obama goes off to the off topic, it's, you can do as much as it would be about the same as yeah, right. So there's a very real difference.
He loses it, man. He loses it, man. He's not able. But, you know, well, I'm saying, with a monitor, Obama is one of the best it's ever been.
Right.
And that's acknowledged by everybody.
Sure.
The guy is good. As much as I hate to say it, he's very, very good.
Okay, now...
Ronald Reagan was a master either way. It didn't matter. He could be on strip reading, or he could be totally freelancing it, and he was good. Trump is great at freelancing.
Yeah.
He just has to learn. He's got to learn. There's certain buzzwords you can't say, Tiger. You just don't say these buzzwords. And if he can get that down, he'll be a great freelancer, too.
Okay, now, speaking of speeches and buzzwords, 61 speeches delivered at the DNC yesterday. Not all of them from the main stage, but 61 speeches given at the DNC. Guess how many times ISIS was mentioned?
Zero.
Not once did they mention the most serious threat facing this country. Well, other than air conditioners, according to John Kerry, who actually stated that air conditioners are a greater threat to America than ISIS.
You know, I'm going to close because I got to go somewhere in a few minutes, but I want to say this one thing, Tom. That is remarkable because for years, the Democrats, including Hillary, including Bill, you know, and everybody, they had talked about Al-Qaeda. Now, Al-Qaeda brought down our World Trade Centers, bombed the Pentagon, bombed the World Trade Center back in 93, you know, drove a plane in the ground in Pennsylvania. They have created, Al-Qaeda has created carnage worldwide. They bombed nightclubs, they bombed hotels, they killed hundreds in a hotel in India a few years ago.
Right.
I mean, all in all, Al-Qaeda is globally known as the deadliest terrorist organization ever put together. And they're willing to talk about Al-Qaeda, but yet you have this group that is committing, as dumb as this sounds, you got to say Al-Qaeda's not as cruel as ISIS.
No.
At least they were willing to bomb you or launch a rocket or something like that, kill you instantly. These guys tortured you, then kill you, and they are the most vicious, vile, barbaric group we have seen since probably the Middle Ages when they would, decapitate you in France and stuff. These guys are brutal, and yet they're not willing to call them out by name. They would Al-Qaeda, but they won't ISIS.
You know why?
And I'm really curious as to why.
I will tell you why. If you recall, I actually broke the story to you about 8 months ago. The leaked State Department document from the, I believe it was the NSA, that showed without a doubt that Barack Obama and Hillary Clinton actually created ISIS. That's why they don't want to draw the attention to ISIS. They created ISIS. They created it. They funded it.
You're right, and how in God's name. By the way, in closing, good news for you. Your Taco Bell thing has been picked up by Breitbart.
Outstanding!
They're now pushing the narrative about it.
Outstanding.
So, I don't know that they're giving you credit
probably
for it, but
not.
They are pushing the narrative.
Brother,
part.
As much as I like credit for stuff that I get put on the web, this one is more important to get the story out than it is to get the credit. So that's good
absolutely.
News. And Breitbart is a very heavily traveled site. It will now go viral and will be talked about. So that's awesome news.
Yep.
That is incredible. That's incredible.
Well, there you go.
And I appreciate you posting it because they probably wouldn't have seen it from my site. I get about one tenth the traffic that I used to get, but that's outstanding. So the Taco Bowl excursion will become a topic on the floor. Goodbye, Hispanics, to Hillary Clinton. I love it. So it's just a regular...
Well, at least some of them. We'll get some of them. That's fine.
Hey, if it only takes 10% of the Hispanic vote away from her, she's done. It doesn't take a lot. It doesn't take a lot to throw an election one way or the other. And we get 10% of the Bernie vote. We get 10% of the Hispanics. We get 10% of the what have you. And she's done.
40 states, baby.
I was just saying it, too. I was just saying 45 states was my call. 45 states or more will win it by.
Yeah, I'm saying 35 to 40, but we'll see what happens. Either way, we win.
Jen Hayman finally pops in.
Ah, Jen, I hope you're feeling better.
I heard she got real hungover from 4 days of partying in Cleveland.
Actually, I think it was that 28 miles a day she had to walk along. She and I had to walk along with that 100-plus degree heat index out there.
A little bit, anyway. A little on the brutal side, huh? All right, brother.
Yes, it was.
You got to run. You're going to a doctor's
office? I got to run. Yeah, I got to go see the doc, see what he says, and I will check in either from the doctor's office or someplace for the jungle. Might get Jen to call in, too, for that, in case the doctor keeps me a bit too long.
There we go. All right, brother.
There you go.
Have a great trip to the doctor's office.
Bye.
Folks, stick around. We can take a quick break, and we're going to be right back. We got more coming up after this. It's the Patriot Radio Show on a Tuesday morning.
Attention patriots and conservative Americans. Have you ever wondered why the Tea Party did so well in 2010, but has not accomplished much since? Have you ever wondered where your money goes when you donate to these various national Tea Party groups, and then what do they do with it? The new blockbuster book, Ego in a Teabag, written by Ken Crow, an original Tea Party organizer and activist, is a tell-all about the seedy side of the Tea Party. Ego in a Teabag exposes the corruption, greed, and deceit behind this great American movement. Along with the exposing of the bat, the book also details how the Tea Party will become the most powerful political organization in America in the coming years. Order your copy today from Amazon.com to be released at the end of April. Just click on the picture of Ken's book on PatriotRadioShow.com and reserve your copy of Ego in a Teabag today.
Hi there, my name is Mark Kranenberg, and welcome to my kitchen. Today we're going to talk about my favorite order from Chicago Steak Company. It's the classic crime assortment. All right, well, let's open up and have a look what's inside. So right away, we've got 2 6-ounce filet mignons. If you know anything about steak, it's really rare to see filet mignons with that kind of marbling in it. Just beautiful steak. And then next, we've got the 2 12-ounce USDA prime strip steaks. Just look at how thick these things are. They're just beautiful. Again, beautifully marbled, amazing steak. Then we've got 2 USDA prime ribeyes. And if you like steak that is just mouthwatering, this is the steak for you. With all that marbling inside, you'll see it's thicker. The marbling is a lot thicker. That just means more moisture throughout your steak. Now we've got 6 USDA prime top sirloin steaks. These are the steaks that everyone's gonna love. Then we're moving into our next package. Next, we have 16 4-ounce gourmet Angus steak burgers. These are amazing burgers that everyone's gonna love. And to top it all off, they give you one container of my favorite steak seasoning of all time, the Chicago Steak Spice, and you're gonna love it too. So there you have the classic prime assortment, my favorite and your ultimate steak experience. So be sure to order your steak today at mychicagosteak.com. I'm Mark. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and we'll see you next time at mychicagosteak.com.
Welcome to the Political Jungle. I am Tom O'Halloran. My co-host Ken Crow and I will guide you through the maddening nightmare of American politics right here every day at 11 a.m. Central Time. We'll take you through the haze and fog of both conservative and liberal spin, help you to see the truth as it is. No matter your political bent, this is the place you can come to vent and be heard at thepoliticaljungle.net.
Tom O'Halloran.
We'll put a boot in your ass. It's the American way. All brought to you courtesy of the red, white, and blue. Oh, oh, my red, white, and blue.
And we are back. It's the Patriot Radio Show on a Tuesday morning. The hypocrisy coming from the DNC just has no end. Besides the 4 miles of 8-foot-high wall they put around the convention center, besides the fact that you need two forms of ID to pick up your credentials, in front of the stage yesterday, after the early mornings, outbursts from the Bernie Sanders crowd, the DNC erected a wall in front of the podium so the unhappy delegates could not rush the stage. So we can't have a wall to protect our nation, according to these Democrats, but they can have a wall to protect them from their own delegates. Ridiculous. A 4-foot-high wall. Mind you, it was the typical concert-type barrier. It wasn't a wall, but a 4-foot-high barrier to keep people away from the stage. In addition to that, all the leftover food after the different meetings and parties and everything, all the leftover food was thrown in the trash. Every bit of leftover food from the Republican National Convention was given to homeless shelters, to soup kitchens. There was no wasted food at all, because Republicans do care about the poor, whereas Democrats just want to take Republicans' money to give to the poor. A huge, huge difference. Next up on the hypocrisy meter is another leaked DNC memo. This one complaining about a gay donor being extremely high maintenance. The leaked memo, which is titled Closeout Menu, dated April 22nd of this year, authored by DNC staffer Judia Lal, who recaps much of the work done with the party's LGBT Leadership Council. Memo contains information on dozens of donors, not all of which are positive. She complains that one donor, named as Darren Glimpf, is extremely high maintenance. Glimpf was one of three hosts for a May 2015 fundraiser in D.C. that was wildly successful in terms of identifying gay black men that are interested in getting involved. However, the three hosts that filled the room incredibly for this event were extremely hard to wrangle for the actual gala. Lal wrote, Darren would like to become involved, but he is hard to get in touch with and extremely high maintenance. I found him to be too much work for what he is worth. Maybe a $5,000 check. So much for the Democrats being the party of the LGBT. We already know they're racist. We already know that they rigged the convention against Bernie Sanders. We already know that they were looking at using his religion against him. We already know that the Democrats on the floor yesterday were comparing Jews in the West Bank to termites. Now Project Veritas is a great organization. I don't have the guy's name in front of me. It's O'Keefe. James O'Keefe. He's the one that broke the story on Acorn, on Planned Parenthood, and so many other issues. He was now interviewing delegates on camera. One of the Democratic operatives said that Hillary Clinton wants a total support or total gun ban. If your goal is an outright gun ban, she said, you need to use such terms as common sense gun legislation to fool the public. As a Hillary Clinton campaign delegate, she said, saying that you want to ban guns altogether, that's going to piss everyone off. This was Clinton alternate delegate Mary Beyer telling Project Veritas. Beyer said Democrats use moderate language when it comes to guns to obscure their true purpose. You have to take that sort of moderate. We just want to have common sense legislation to keep our children safe. She said that you say shit like that and people will buy into it. But when you say we want to ban the guns, they go crazy. The truth comes out a little bit at a time. Meanwhile, Julian Assange from WikiLeaks made the statement, my next leak will ensure Hillary's arrest. Julian Assange has said that his leaks have obtained information that, when revealed soon, will guarantee a Hillary Clinton indictment. During a recent interview with ITV, Assange said the release will provide enough evidence to get her elected. WikiLeaks has already published 30,322 emails from her private server spanning from June of 2010 to August of 2014. While he didn't exactly specify what was in the emails, he did say that WikiLeaks had accumulated a lot of material about Hillary Clinton, which could proceed to an indictment. He also hinted that the email slated for publication contained additional information about the Clinton Foundation. This is getting back to the Clinton cash scandal that I think will be what finally puts her in jail. He is going to release it. He said his next release will be, I believe, August 12th. It's not in this bulletin here, but I read it yesterday. It will be an August 12th thing. Just off the convention floor, the DNC has turned a women's bathroom into an all-gender bathroom at the Wells Fargo Arena. And the women are not happy about it. At least one person of the DNC is upset. She says, I don't need no man in the stall next to me when I go to the bathroom. We need a male and a female. We got our own bathrooms. We got personal business. I'm trying to keep it real. It's privacy. I need privacy. So even some Democrats have common sense. But I think the biggest news of the day, as far as the convention goes, was the leaked memo that that Sanders had written to the Clinton campaign to sell out, sell his endorsement of Hillary Clinton. Hillary's endorsement from Bernie Sanders and all it cost Hillary and the campaign was a private plane for Bernie Sanders so he could fly around like one of the elites. That and credit for helping her win the election. Unfortunately, Bernie Sanders thought that he was in control of the movement, but the movement had gotten too big and they were true radicals in the movement. They are not going to endorse, embrace, or vote for Hillary Clinton. They are going full tilt rogue. This memo was found in a hotel room that he had stayed at back in early June. That's our show for today, my friends. We've actually gone a little bit over. Time got away from me. But God bless you and yours. This is Tom O'Halloran. I'm out.